Hi guys, welcome. This is Unfinished. My name is SK Gitonga. Thank you for joining. Today we're talking about the new university funding model, which entails a band from 1 to 5, which offers a 30% to 70% scholarship according to their level of need. Which takes us to our first question. Do you think the new funding model is practical? Let me know what you think in the comment section.
I guess a pana because you know, like, mtu unapata maybe our first year, so unasikia mtu amekuwa band 4 and 5, unapata like situation yao ya home hawajiwezi, so like watu wengine watopt kwenda maybe hizo mativet ama hadi kuachana na shule
hii ya kwanza. Hii sasa ya mapanda sio, wana consider hiyo pesa ya mzazi vile anapata. Unachaza hizo makea repin. Of course, hata ile ya kitambo ilikuwa na hivyo. Ilikuwa na hizo makea repin, but walikuwa tu wana give according to the course you are doing. Na wanaangalia fee. For example, kama unafanya medicine, pa hiya tuseme, for example, ni 500,000 academic year. So wanaangalia your course. Wanaona, fee unafaa kulipa, for example, 500,000. Ndio umalize hiyo wakati you are government sponsored. Sasa wanaangalia, then wanakugrade. Lakini sasa hii ya sasa, yeah, wa, as okay, as my perspective, mimi naona waangalili hiyo. Wanafuata tu mshahara ya mzazi, maybe na hizo maneno za KRA, ma payroll hizo wanaangalia hizo. Mzazi kama kuna chop, so unakuwa pressed kulingana na chop mimi mzazi anafanya.
I don't think. Sababu is like in a divide. Naona sisi wote tuko yuko. Huwezi angalia sababu mimi niko na hii simu na ule yako na simu ndogo. So mimi kwangu hayuko sawa. Kila mtu wako yuko. If inafanyika, ifanyike equally. Yeah, isikuwe na classes.
Haijakuwa practical juu inaumiza watu wengi. Like unapata mtu mwenye anatoka kwa poor background, amekuwa placed on band 5. Uvicha wezi pata hiyo fee yote. So inaumiza watu, lakini kwa maoni yangu, it is not practical.
The new funding model is not functional. In fact, it is discriminatory and it should be scrapped. Yes, simply because it is not justifiable. When they say they have set someone in a certain band, and you go back on the grassroots to realize that they were not supposed to be in that band, how do you justify that? So, to reduce the discrimination, it should be scrapped. Yes.
Mimi ningesema haifai kabisa. Haifai kosi. Afadhali turudi kwa ile yetu ya kitambo. Hivyo tu. To me, it's discriminatory in nature. And it is a way of denying children or students a chance to education, whereby in our constitution, education, basic education is a right. It's not a privilege. So when you put these bands, it means there's a child who is going to miss education, not because kwa makosa yake, lakini yeye ajui kwa nini anamiss. So I see it as a very discriminatory process that should be scrapped completely. And then you go back to the model which was giving a student equal opportunities, because every child has a right to education.
One thing I just want to add to the government, let us make education free from lower primary, from nursery to university. And the government must find a way of incorporating the corporate world. For instance, banks, Safaricom, the telecommunication industry, the banking industry, and many other industries, manufacturing industries, so that they intervene. Because these industries will help, especially the college student at the university, in research and development. And this thing called CDF, it should just be disbanded and ensure that it is incorporated into making sure that education is free. Construction of our secondary schools, construction of our primary schools, to make sure that the learning environment is superb, whereby students from nursery or from lower primary can start doing their research. Things or laboratory things, the science things, the historical things, the librarian things, yani in every field, they can start nurturing their talents from that area. So education can be made free in this, can be made free in this country by ensuring that government expenditures are lowered. So you see each and every cabinet secretary, ministers are going to using their fuel guzzlers, which are being funded by the taxpayers' money. So I think if the government can say that, maybe they use PASAT. Maybe certain expenditures are reduced. The CDF is scrapped, all put in education sector. I think we will be good to go.
Yeah, it's practical, though I don't know much about it. But I would consider like taking new option and trying out new things. Anytime until one like a strategy fails, it's when you go for the next choice that you made. Yeah.
For me, it's working. Yo, 20% new reaper. No, I'm sasi ana afford to reaper. Yeah, na sometimes ana nitumia do. Yeah, life to iko sawa.
Cheating too. Yeah, only that.
The new funding model, mi kwangu, no, it's not practical because hiyo funding, hiyo nini imeumiza wase wengi juu ukiangalia venye hiyo kitu inaplaiwa awa, kuna our favor side zote ya yeah. Juu unaweza pata mse wale oyai kabisa band 5 then unapata connection hivi 2-3 mtu ameingia band 1 yeah.
I would say it's not practical because there are no parameters to measure one's capabilities of getting the funds. Our next question is, do you think students should be admitted in school despite their bad financial situation? Let me know what you think in the comment section.
I guess, yeah. You see, kila mtu anaweza afford hiyo. Hadi tu hiyo kidogo unapata, like sisi, kurudi shule tunafaa tulipe full fee. Tunalipanga full fee ndo rudi shule. So utapata kunao, hadi kwa afford to your juu minimum I guess ni 16k. Nipate maybe si mtu peke yake, like aishi peke yake. Maybe ako na siblings wengine na pia wanadai kwenda shule. So I guess wangekuwa anaacha tu watu wanarudi shule hivyo.
I don't think because unajua as previous loan zuwa zilikuwa zina ni kama upkeep. Sasa ukiishi hapa ndani na hata hauna hiyo upkeep uwezo wa kumudu masomo yako, it will be so difficult. Unaweza pata hata ume drop from school, umeingia maneno ya wizi hapa ndani, at least upate kitu kule. Yeah.
I think so. Students should be admitted without that fund because ukiangalia most of their parents, their incomes are 10,000-20,000 and below. And maybe a parent has like 3 children. There's one thing they are not factoring. You may be having 3 to 4 children who are in university. Then you are earning 50,000. If you divide 50 by 4, you are earning 10 for a child. So when you are basing one child on that salary of 50,000 and the other children, where are they? So consider a parent who has many children and also a child is not supposed to be denied that if, right to education. At because if I kufanya exam, what has the child done to miss education? You see makosa ya mtoto, na pia si makosa ya mzazi, because mzazi anataka mtoto asome. We have enough money. Me, I think hii kitu ya pesa inagawanyishwa huko inaenda CDF, inaenda mbazali, mtoto mmoja anapata mbazali tano na mwingine hapati. I think mtoto hafai kukosa hiyo nini, kukosa hiyo, akose kwenda shule because of that.
Mtoto hafai kukosa kuadmitiwa kwa shule. Juu si makosa yake na si makosa ya mzazi akose pesa. Ni kulingana na vile nchi yetu uchumi iko. So mtoto ako na right ya kuadmitiwa, mzazi ajipange vile mtoto wake ataendelea akisoma.
That is a barrier. And education in a developing country should not have barriers for anyone when it comes to education. Creating barriers will only take us back to the days of before independence. How do you liberate without education? So barriers, those barriers is what we need to run away from. The country needs to create an environment where every other child, every other person accesses education to the level that they choose to, without barriers. Yes.
Students who are incapable of funding their education, And that's why I commenced by saying that education should be free to cater for these sharp students. Because you find that some students are bypassed and they are going for certain courses. That is why I started by saying that education should be free to cater for all these things. This issue of funding, these are our bureaucracies which will really disadvantage all the merit, the people from backgrounds who cannot, from humble background, I mean. Yeah.
Yeah, they should. For the first thing, as this person, as they are being admitted to the university, they know that they must have the capabilities of finances, but we just have different ways of gaining that capability. So there's someone who will do it, maybe in installments, time to time, like slowly, but at the end of the 4 years, ama the years that the course is taking, atakuwa memanage. Some of us got into the university and we hustled our fees out of there, like got into hustles and to come manage kulipa school fees. So denying this person because he doesn't have the financial capabilities, it will be cutting the dream short.
Yeah, inafai kwe hivyo juu mostly unapata pengine what students are working. Our students are working wanakuanga from poor backgrounds. Ndio unapata msia akona ile hardworking ya juu kabisa juu anajua home hakuna kitu. So inafaa pewe hiyo opportunity ya kuendelea na studies zake ndo masomo yake yaendelee.
Yeah, at some point, yeah. Because, ndio, education is universal. Kila mtu anasaidia tu apate.